Good morning, this is David B69, and today we will bring you the following game. Before anybody comments and stuff, they wondered or anything, it's like, oh, why don't you get one of those things where you can take the footage from it. Well, the PS4 that comes out later this year will have the ability to take all this and just transmit it automatically to Twitch TV, so it's sort of kind of silly to do anything else. Now, this is like my second take. I was doing a first take and the game was going fine, and then my wife and kids came in like really late into the game, and I wasn't expecting them to come home so early, which basically affected the sound, which affected everything else, and instead of pausing and continuing later and editing out that part, it was just easier just to restart, and that's what I am doing today. First thing you notice is when you're loading up, it takes a while to load up to connect. Should never take that long. The whole 200 people online right now throughout the country. Exciting. This thing is all messed up. When I first loaded it up and everything, I was playing San Francisco. And when I went to go and load it and everything, it said it was 0 and 0. We're not going to be playing San Francisco. We're going to be playing Boston today. First thing I want to do is I am not starting Felipe Aumont in this game. Wow, I have nobody who has any kind of energy on this team. You know, I'm probably wind up going to have to put Aumont. Yeah, I'm going to have to use Aumont. And then put in Swimmer later and go Horst. Why isn't Lannan starting? Lannan, see, this is the thing. It's like I simulated this stuff and it totally changed what pitchers do what. So I'm gonna have Lannan start. He should be the starter. And I don't know what this game thinks sometimes. I didn't even look at my lineup and change that, which is probably all screwed up.
Fenway Park in Boston. A sellout? Is there any other? John Lester, an ace. He's going to be on the mound looking for a victory in this ballgame. And happy Memorial Day, a special day for the veterans. 2K Sports welcomes you to our Major League Baseball broadcast. And as he gets going against these Philadelphia hitters, what do you think's in store?
Well, for John Lester, he's got that exceptional fastball, kind of hard-pouring action on it. Then he'll cut that fastball as well, run it in on the hands of the right-handed hitters. He's the complete package. He's a competitor, a bulldog on the mound, and he gets away pitching up in the zone.
Get a chance to look at what Charlie Manuel's thinking lineup-wise.
What the heck?
What are you looking at, John?
When Jimmy Rollins first came up to the big leagues, he was a speed guy.
Okay, I have Michael Young playing first. Ruiz is catching in a three-hole. Kratz is DHing. Utley's playing third base.
it'll be Ben Revere leading us off. Well, the Phillies took the loss yesterday. They were hoping to take the series after splitting games one and two. They ended up grabbing one game only.
Okay, I can honestly say this is totally screwed up.
You're playing very consistent baseball right now. Sometimes as a manager, that's all you can expect out of your club.
Cut fastball, swung on and missed, 0-1. Certainly the players would like to do a little bit better than the 500 they're in right now.
Well, absolutely. You know a 500 team's not going to win a division, but they have to improve on that, and they have to turn it around right now.
Totally use analog sticks for hitting and pitching. And...
swung and a fly ball. And he's on. That's a nice way to jumpstart your offense. We'll take a look here and see where the Red Sox are positionally around the diamond. And John, how about individual factors up there?
Will Middlebrook manning the hot corner at third base for his team today. A lot of things he can do. Great fielder, but what you want to watch is he has an unbelievable throwing arm.
Now a chance here to see where the Philadelphia Phillies sit in the rankings in the National League. Fourth in stolen bases, eighth in batting average with runners in scoring position, and they're in the top 10 in team batting average. That depth and length of the lineup paying big dividends for this team as they seem to find ways to get base hits.
At the belt, Lester kicks, throws, and they pitch out. Nobody's moving. Here's the 1-0. That one is swung on and missed by Young. It'll even it up. 250 is average last season against the Red Sox in the games played here in Boston.
I like the clouds effect in the background. It kind of looks nice.
1-2. Good moving cutter. And it's 1-2 now.
If you saw his last game, you got a chance to see that he swung the bat well in that one, picking up a couple of knocks.
There's a ground ball.
Well, that's just great hand-eye coordination right here. He saw the defense, knew where he wanted to go with it, and he did it.
And a really measured, confident swing right there. Excellent touch, John.
Everything going right for him that time.
Chance to drive in a run right here for Carlos Ruiz.
They've counted on him a lot lately. He's picked up 5 hits in his last 13 at-bats.
And in the last series before this one, he was really rolling. Very good couple of games for him.
First pitch, way out of the zone, ball one. Now let's take a moment here to see the breakdown of the pitches that have yielded hits.
Guys, the cutter's the pitch I'm watching here. It's been hit twice already.
The thing is, with no outs, still this game just getting underway, he's definitely got to figure out something else because that pitch isn't working early.
There's a ground ball. And Revere is home. There's the throw. And he gets there in time, second base. A little warm-up action going in the bullpen. That's a right-hander up and throwing.
Well, they're going to wait for the right-handed hitter on deck to get announced, and then they'll probably make the move to the pen.
You love to see this kind of an effort. This is a single that becomes a double.
You take a look at this slide. He goes in very hard into second base, full speed, able to beat a play.
And that was speed.
Well, the pressure's mounting for John Lester here, Gary. Let's see if he's up to it.
And he and his team are down just a run, but with this kind of mess out there right now, he's got to find some quick outs.
Gary, he needs a ground ball here. He has to keep the ball in the infield and avoid the sacrifice fly.
Two men in scoring position, still no one out. He delivers, starts him out with a fastball for a strike.
He looked like he was looking for a pitch out over the plate. That fastball down and in locked him up a little bit.
And that one gets away from the catcher. Missed with a fastball outside, 2-1. Cut fastball is Vine, and it's even at 2.
Well, that's a guy up there who's trying to do damage with one swing. Comes up empty on that cutter.
Swing and a drive, deep left center. This one to Ellsbury. As he hopes, runners on the move. Here's a look at the standings in the Eastern Division race as May's winding down. It's the Blue Jays in first, Yankees in second place. In third, the Red Sox. Rays are fourth, and for the Orioles, last place.
Well, the pressure's mounting for John Lester here, Gary. Let's see if he's up to it.
And he finds himself in an early pitching jam here, down by 1-2-1.
They have to limit the damage, and they have a chance to be all right. They just have to settle down and make good pitches.
That one taken by Utley for a strike.
It's been a tough several games for him, only 9 hits in his last 59. Yeah, it's been a battle for him to hit since the early month of May. Just seemed to lose his stroke. He's got to get himself back on track a little bit. I think he needs to focus on going the other way and staying on the ball.
And Pedroia picks it up. That's one. But he'll hang on to that, so they will get one. Now look at the pitching staffs who are piling up the K's. Rays number one. The A's second. The Red Sox third. Yankees fourth. And at number five on the list, the White Sox.
Well, hitters have done a lot of walking back to the dugout, shaking their head this year, as this team can log the strikeouts with the quality arms and locations.
No, this is one of the comments I had and everything.
Luis is third.
It's like somehow
just misses 1-0.
Lance Mixer is 19. Somehow he got changed to number 20 during the process of the season, which should have never happened.
Now the 1-0 fastball low 2-0.
That two-seam fastball is such
a he's wearing Mike Schmidt's number.
Round ball outs, but two, it sets up his other pitches.
Here's the pitch. That one's wide of the mark, and it's 3-0.
Got to really credit the way this offense is working the count here in the first inning. They understand the game decided by middle relievers today. They may get this starter out early.
This one's finally over for a strike, and it's 3-1.
He takes that strike to go 3-1, but still a hitter's count looking for a cripple pitch right here.
And this is bounced foul to the left side.
Was that ball four?
3-2 on the way. Hit hard on the ground to short. Pedroia throws on to first in time to retire the side. And it didn't take long. Our first two runs. First inning, trouble coming. Philly in the lead, 2-0. And we'll get to see John Lannon pitching. He'll get the start for Philadelphia. And Steve, as he gets into this Boston lineup, what are we going to see?
Well, it's got to be the ability to locate and change speeds for John Lannon. There's nothing special about his stuff anymore. He has to rely upon the defense behind him, which means he has to work his sequence and throw strikes.
On the way, a swing line to left center. And the leadoff man of this ball game's on board. See if they get it started early. Makes it easily, no effort to get him. He throws, safe at third, just ahead of that throw. Nice job on this one, and if he doesn't go down into the dirt, he's not going to get a triple.
Well, you're right, great hustle. He was at full speed out of the batter's box, and it was the slide directly into the bag that made a difference.
Boston won yesterday, so maybe a bit of momentum here. Very pleased to have split that series 2-2 against the Indians. A swing and a foul off to the right side. So, last time up, they stacked up the runs to get a victory.
That 8-run lead, that to me tells me you've dominated them.
Strike two with that. No balls, two strikes. Pedroia now, shorten the swing, shorten up on the bat.
He's come on strong and stayed through a nice stretch right now, going 14 for his last 32.
And lately he's been hitting a lot of home runs, really zoned in on the pitches they've thrown his way.
Lannon winds up for the 1-2 pitch. Swing and a ball hit very high, soaring straight away left field. This two-run homer ties the game, a clutch piece of hitting.
That's kind of creepy.
Well, this is the way to answer right back. They fell behind in the top half, but got back on the board and tied things up.
And you don't see that happen very often. After you've fallen behind, sometimes the wind is taken out early.
Well, I tell you what, nice response by the offense. Now they got to see if they keep adding on runs.
This is how the Red Sox are lining up. In our scouting report, John, who are we watching for today?
Will Middlebrooks has a chance to be that elite power hitter in the game, especially for a third baseman. He came up, he hit a lot of home runs, but he had the injury bug. If he can stay healthy, big numbers are coming his way.
And Ortiz lets it go. That's going to be outside four, a ball.
You see when you get a little hit and stuff. The
now the 1-0 pitch.
Eye kind of gets a little shaky, which means your accuracy isn't as good as it normally is.
Away from the hitter, you have to get great extension out in front. Nice job of pitching.
Generally, as soon as you get an out and everything, it goes away.
Wow. Slider just off the black that time, 2-1.
He throws the breaking ball at the hitter's head, trying to catch the corner up and in, trying to get him to flinch. He didn't take the bait, didn't swing the bat.
And Ortiz with a swing and a miss for a strike. Count is even up.
That changeup away is one of the most effective pitches because when the hitter's cool, he starts to pull off the ball. He can only hit an inside pitch. He can't possibly reach the outside pitch unless he breaks down his swing.
Well, he finished that one off with a strikeout. Nice pitch.
Now, Gary, that's an outstanding slider. That great late action with two strikes. Not much you can do with that one. Tough one to hit.
And here's the defensive alignment for the Phillies. Any picks, John?
Jimmy Rollins has been a fantastic fielder for a long, long time, and he hasn't slowed up a bit. Great throwing arm and great instincts at the shortstop position.
Lannon with a delivery. Hard ground and a short. Rollins. And that's in plenty of time for the out. And the upcoming schedule for the Phillies. Then they will come back home to take on the Brewers. Ricky Weeks in a strong lineup. Boy, there's some great competition in that set of games. That'll be Wednesday through Saturday. And after that, they'll be home against the Brewers. Aramis Ramirez will be part of that Brew crew. That should be a great series. They really match up well. Yeah, lots of home games. That's always a good thing.
They're playing the Red Sox. It's a home and home series during the end of the month.
Hits in his last 49 May. Bats.
And you look back at when this all started, go back to mid-May. That's when he started getting hot.
A swing, line drive, deep left field. And Brown puts that away to retire the side. They come up with two runs to pull even. We got a stalemate going in Boston. To lead it off, here's Jimmy Rollins. A swing and a fly ball to left center field. This one's going to be fielded by Harrison. And he gets over to take care of it. A moment to check out the stats of the lowest batting average against. The Athletics, number one. Second, the Blue Jays. Third, the Yankees. Red Sox, fourth. And at number five on the list, the Rays.
Well, the opposition's had a tough time putting the ball in play against this staff and really holding the opponent's batting average down. So real quality pitching and effort from the staff.
And we're going to see Brown here.
Well, the Phillies had a lot of questions coming into last season, some injury concerns from some of the veterans, and it kind of set them back a little bit in terms of what they were able to accomplish as a team.
And set bat underway, 1-0 after that first pitch missed. Steve was talking about the Phillies and the injuries to the veterans. I think not having some of those leaders healthy really affected them, especially in the road, John.
And it's tough to ask young players to take the place of star players who have been injured or are going to be out for a long time. The Phillies tried it. It didn't work out for them. They were a very poor offensive team early in the season. Late in the season, though, when they got those guys back, they were a better team, played great on the road, but they're just not going to be able to compete if guys in the middle of their lineup can't play a full season.
Now Lester sets up, 2-1. Little fly ball to shallow right. And that's going to be a base hit for Brown.
A good piece of hitting right there with one out. Now let's see what they can do with him now that they've got a man on first.
And we've got Galvis here.
You see that every aspect of the Boston Red Sox struggled last year, and their ace, John Lester, not immune to it. He posted his worst season since becoming a full-time starter.
Ball is downstairs. One ball, no strikes. Well, the Red Sox troubles certainly mimic Lester's, or perhaps vice versa. John Lester, not a good year, 9-14, and an amazing 4.82 ERA, John.
Unexplainable. The stuff that he has, he should never lose more games than he wins. He should never have an ERA over 4. I don't know what went on with him. I don't know if it was, you know, everything was going on with his team and the clubhouse, what happened in 2011 affected him, but he's going to bounce back, and his team's going to bounce back. He has to be a big part of that.
The 1-2 on its way.
You're out.
Swing and a miss. Strike him out with a breaking ball. Two down.
81 miles per hour with some solid movement here.
He decides to take a hack at a pitch up and away, but he just couldn't put the barrel on it.
Nice piece of pitching right there, John.
Well, it certainly was. You got to give credit to the pitcher for giving him something eye level to chase at.
And a chance here with two down for Ben Revere. And he steals off and then he gets away with it. He's one of the league's best. Base runner at first, Brown, and he'll start him out. Oh, that runs inside. That got him.
Well, that's going to leave a mark right there. A big old welt on him. He's going to need some ice when he gets back to the dugout.
And that brings Michael Young to the plate.
Well, remember that hit batter we just saw? Now two runners on base. A little rally starting here, and maybe the pitcher getting a little bit rattled.
Here's the delivery. Takes a big hack at that one, but misses one strike. Now you watch and see how the hitters react to it. Are they looking for that next pitch down the middle, or they think maybe they got to wait him out?
And the pitcher has to regroup. He's got to settle down out there, not panic, and get back in the strike zone.
And that's a strike. Young's going to have to be very careful on this next pitch.
Now, Gary, the pitcher pulled the string on this one. It looks like a fastball, and then it just dies out as it gets to the plate. Good late movement.
This one's going to be fielded by Hairston. That'll do it as they put that one away. So they pick up no runs, one hit, and strand a couple. We are still deadlocked in Boston. For those of you just coming on board, Gary Thorne with Steve Phillips and John Krutt, bringing you Major League Baseball on 2K Sports. Middlebrooks in the batter's box.
Not quite his best stretch right now, picking up just 11 hits over his last 46. Got a tough time for him at the plate, struggling since the middle of May, just not producing like he can. He just lost his rhythm. He looks really uncomfortable in there.
And landing wide that time, that will be a ball.
Well, that right there is a really good pitch, just missing the outside corner. Give the batter a lot of credit, though. That is one of the toughest pitches to lay off of, that hard fastball away.
2-1.
Middlebrooks will watch. That one's up high. 364, a lifetime number against the Phillies. Landon with a delivery.
Ball.
Now Will Middlebrooks with a 3-1 count. The 3-1 on the way. There's a swing and a smash. And Revere's going to play it. No problem for him as he gets that out. Here's a look at teams getting it done on our league leaderboard, the staffs that have the lowest ERA. Number one, the Cardinals. Second, the Phillies. Third spot, Giants. The Dodgers, fourth. And it's the Brewers, fifth best.
Let's talk about pitching and defense and being important to winning. Clearly, for them, pitching is already something that's a major part of their success this season.
And in the batter's box, it's Ross. Good pitch from Lennon. Swung on and missed.
Well, that's an awfully big hack for such a slow, slow off-speed pitch. Came up empty.
And Ross lets it go outside for a ball.
Looking to build offensively off his last game where he had a couple of RBIs and trying to carry that into this one as well.
That's cut out and missed, 1-2. Landon winds up for the 1-2 pitch. Ross puts it into the Mother Earth. That's two gone.
And now a chance to see where the Red Sox sit in the American League running backs. First in home runs, first in runs, and they're also the number one team in slugging percentage That ability to drive the ball in the gap and take the extra bases, it's all about power and slugging for this lineup.
And it's Johnny Gomes on the box now.
Ice game just not coming naturally to him right now. Struggling a bit, 6 for his last 44 at-bats.
It has been a tough time for him at the plate. His struggles date back to mid-May. Just not producing like he can.
Well, that and goes right at him, strike two.
When a hitter gets fooled, he starts to open up his swing. That means he can only really handle a pitch on the inner third of the plate. He played with fire right there.
This one is hit deep by Gomes. That'll be off the Gray Monster out there in left. Gomes headed towards third.
He's hit coming up in the zone over the heart of the plate. Good piece of hitting drives that ball.
Boy, if there's a pitcher wants back. There's one right there.
That's good pitch recognition, good two-strike approach.
Underwood at the plate. Taps this one foul to the right. The pitch. Strike two at the knees. Nothing in two.
Great stuff from the pitcher. Now he's ahead 0-2. He can go in so many different directions.
Solid contact made, but that foul ball up in the air is going to be off on the right side. Changeup swung on and missed. That will retire the side. They get a man to third, but can't bring him home. We got a stalemate going in Boston. Not a whole lot of sun out here in Fenway right now. Somewhat cloudy. Clouds moving around above us. And Ruiz settles in. For his team, he's number two in hits. This one's grounded foul, wide at first.
Well, he's getting the job done this year, no question about it. Such production, so consistent.
And he fouls another one off. At the belt, Lester kicks, throws, and the cut fastball's in there, strike three, one away.
Well, a great job getting it 0-2. That third pitch, unhittable.
Guess he figured why waste a pitch, save the arm, he did.
Nice job.
Kratz is in the batter's box, he's ready to go. First pitch of the AB.
Strike one.
Good pitch from Lester, swung on and missed. And Ross setting his target. And Lester's wide that time for a ball.
They went with the big curveball off the plate, trying to get him to reach for it, but he lays off.
1-1 pitch, a fastball, cut on, missed, 1-2.
And he's keeping him on that toes with his fastball. You know way you can catch up to that one.
There's contact. He drove it well. This one to Ellsbury. He comes up with it easily here. There's more MLB this Thursday. We'll see Justin Upton and the Arizona Diamondbacks. They find themselves at Rangers Ballpark in Arlington to take on Texas. That one will get underway at 8 Eastern.
And I guess the roster update is that warmed at the beginning of this game.
It's solid like effort from Lester.
Season didn't
stuff.
Take place because
how's he getting these first pitches across? Well, let's take a look.
Patience for a hitter is important. In this game, we'll show you how important it really is. Four of their hits have come after the count has gone 1-0.
First pitch fastball misses badly that time, 1-0.
I hate that his sleeve looks like a 28 when it's really 26.
Here's the pitch.
Look at his back, it's 26, but even then it bleeds a little bit.
One for nine, career batter off left.
Looks sloppy.
Good looking fastball, called the ball low, 2-1. Here's the 2-1. Utley swings and misses at that one. That evens up the count. fastball well off the mark, and it's full 3-2. Payoff pitch. That one fouled off by Utley. And here's the 3. Swing and lined up the middle. And that is in there, the go-ahead run on board.
Well, you would like to see him done it on the first pitch, get that base hit. But if it took a while, it doesn't matter if you're the hitter. As long as that base hit gets put in the column, he is rewarded and he deserves it. Well, you wonder he had the energy to run to first base after seeing that many pitches, fouling off pitches, taking tough pitches, but he did. Well, thank goodness he only had to run 90 feet because I'd imagine he was pretty tired.
It's going to be Nick's now.
He's been trying to work through what's been a real difficult spell for him, going just 1 for his last 7 at-bats. An uphill battle for him over the last 4 games. He's not able to get much done. Got to be more aggressive.
Ball 1 started off the at-bat. It's 1-0. A career and a low career 150 hitter against the Red Sox.
And just hasn't ever been able to get dialed in against this team throughout his career.
Throws to first, sign is retired. No runs at a base hit. They leave one man on at first. Still a tie game in Boston.
Don't ask me where he's going. He's going like to the outfield.
And it's Jacoby Ellsbury at the plate. He's the top 10 in stolen bases for the league. First pitch on the way. There's a swing and a ground ball. It is through, and the go-ahead runs on board.
Anytime you get a guy on base with no outs,
it didn't matter if you're way over his head.
Greater. This is what this team needed.
They were like way over his head, and it didn't matter or anything, even though it's like the guy probably would be on second or third by now.
And right now, top 5 in runs batted in the league.
But that's okay. My guy can throw an error in the outfield, and it doesn't matter in this game.
First pitch of the at-bat now. And Landon has him 0-1 with a called strike. Here's the pitch.
Swing. Oops. That's gone.
In the air, deep left center field.
You're kidding.
That'll be off the gray monster out there in left. And he easily gets...
Nobody ran?
Boy, what a time now.
Can't tell that it was a high hit off the board?
And I think that pitch right there just got away from him. 0-1 pitch, throw it right down the middle of the plate. Not a good location.
And you'll get hurt, John, pretty much any time you do that. That's the kind of mistake you have to limit.
Absolutely. We'll have to see how he handles this next batter.
And Ortiz ready for the first pitch. Foul! And it's fouled off.
You can at the beginning of an at-bat, you can go to visit the mound and fix your composure and stuff by having the manager visit you. Generally, it could get a lot worse than what it is right now.
So
I'm not overly worried about it right at this point.
Clearly one of the stories for this team over the last bunch of games, going 13 for his last 25 at-bats.
Try to change up here.
He's been rock solid lately in the middle of that lineup, really doing the job, bringing the runners home, paying dividends.
Speed up his bat and throw a fastball inside and see if I can get him out with it.
And he strikes him out, catches Ortiz flat-footed.
Very little movement on this pitch at 93 miles per hour, courtesy of Kinkin.
Well, you don't want to get caught looking at a fastball like that.
They set him up beautifully with the change of speed, but you still think he'd be able to at least try and take a hack.
In the batter's box, Santa Lamacchia. And taking a look here, the pitch types that he's thrown today that have yielded hits.
Well, guys, that changeup of his has been hit 2 times so far in this one.
Well, John, they definitely have batted that pitch around, but it hasn't been the only one. He's given up 5 hits so far. We're still just in the 3rd inning, but it's not a good sign for him right now. With that speed, Ellsbury is always a threat to run. They better keep him close.
Fastball just misses, and he falls behind 2-0.
Well, you saw the catcher right there setting up inside, and the pitcher just missed off the plate. Still a pretty good pitch, though.
Slider misses badly. He's down 3-0.
Well, this is awful right here. He's falling behind this hitter 3-0. Let's see if he can come back to get him.
Lannon with a delivery. And that misses. Ball four. He has loaded him up.
I don't know about this call, Gary. He must have a lot of confidence in that changeup. But with runners on base and a three-ball count, you've got to throw a strike there. Now he loads up the bases.
And it's Hairston batting. And he'll be swinging with the bases loaded.
But, Gary, they got a big opportunity now to take the lead in this situation.
Dime's going to be called here. They want to go out and talk things over on the hill.
That's going to be a conference time, Gary. They might not take him out here, but pretty likely they're going to make a change soon. They may be stalling for time.
Yeah, I don't know what that batter's doing. He's like, I'm going to hit you. I don't really care. I'm just going to hit you. And there's the thin young Charlie. Charlie wishes he doesn't have it. It's like as few wrinkles as it is in here. Maybe they had Botox surgery for him beforehand.
Three on and one out. And starts him out here. Hit in the air to center field. And there's the RBI. Hairston with a hit and the grip. And Pedroia also in. And he'll stop at second base. That'll be a two-run double. Take a moment to check out how much that two-bagger helps their cause. Here's the win expectancy graph.
A good piece of hitting and great piece of base running right there, Gary. I wasn't sure he was going to make it, but now he's on second.
That's a great asset right there to be able to exploit opportunities offensively, and that's what he's done.
And credit the base coach for knowing where the players were positioned on the field to allow him to get in there.
Middlebrook's in the batter's box. What we're seeing here is just a great push. Been able to jump out in front here in this ball game. You love to get the other team down early.
Excellent approach by this lineup so far in the game. They've got to be pleased to get out in front early.
Manager's got to love it. It takes a little pressure off the manager, too, when you get the hitters going this early in a ball game.
Well, you know what? It's the solid approach at the plate. They clearly have a plan as to how they wanted to attack this pitcher, and they're executing it to perfection.
And Will Middlebrooks watches that one go by. The count is even. Average last year for him, 364 against the Phillies. And Rivera's going to play it. Two men have been put away. Here's a look at the standings in the Eastern Division race as Mays winding down. Marlins out in front, first place. In second place, it's the Nationals. Third goes to the Phillies. Fourth place, hey,
the worst
Rays.
Team is the
and
Marlins.
And in last place, the Mets. And in the batter's box, it's Ross. What's he doing to start these hitters out? Let's take a look at how he's beginning.
Well, when he's throwing that first pitch strike, it leads to effectiveness. He's got five guys out after throwing a first pitch strike.
The first pitch. Changeup just misses. 1-0. 0-3 last year against Lannon. The 1-0 pitch. And it's a called strike to Ross. He takes a fastball for a strike. Now it's 1-2. Lannon winds up for the 1-2 pitch. And it goes foul. Ross lays off that one high.
Well, third inning of this ballgame, Gary, clearly he's run into a little bit of a brick wall and up over 20 pitches right here.
Lannon with a delivery.
Ball three.
That's low. Ross.
Wow.
Here's a chance to take a look at how this pitcher has been doing in terms of getting hitters to chase pitches outside the zone.
Well, when you break it down, his command just hasn't been there. You have to earn outside corner of the plate or the inside.
Headed for the middle, Galvis. And he throws on to first. That'll retire the side. So for John Lannon, he heads to the dugout. He's allowed four runs to score. Puts a deuce on the scoreboard for the third inning. And it'll be the Phillies. John Farrell trying to make the decisions of bring a W. Let's see how it's going. Things have been going right for him. His ball club today, last half inning, they proved productive. Now they're looking to expand that lead. Swing and a miss by Rollins. Strike one.
He has not been seeing the ball the way he'd like, going just 11 for his last 57.
You know it's been a battle for him to hit well since the first part of May. Just hasn't been getting it done.
Rollins makes contact. That's fouled off.
Foul!
Strike three, swung on by Rollins, and no luck.
I'll tell you, that kind of breaking ball in the low 80s is awfully tough to hit.
Fantastic piece of pitching to get that out, John.
Well, that's the part of pitching you love. He's looking for a fastball, he's expecting a fastball, and then just drop one right off the table. What a pitch.
And we're going to see Brown here. He's in his fourth year now. At the belt, Lester kicks, throws. Can't get him to chase that one outside, ball one. And here's a quick summary of how this guy's mixing up his pitches. How's he doing?
Well, he's done exactly that. He's changed speeds, he's mixed up all his pitches, and the great thing is he's throwing them all for strikes.
It's unpredictability. The hitters can't think along with him. They don't know what he's going to throw next, keeping them off balance.
Line towards second. So Brown is retired. Here's what the Red Sox schedule looks like. And it's a road trip to take on the Yankees and their great first baseman, Mark Teixeira.
I'm curious.
That team trumped them in their last set of games.
Okay, now can I do a substitution? Yeah, it just says he's cold. Yes.
Games. That is a four-game road series. And it's a road trip to take on the Yankees, led by that great center fielder, Curtis Granderson. The team bested them in the last series between the two. So they'll be on the road quite a bit over this next stretch. And that'll bring Ryan Howard to the plate. He's going to come on as a pinch hitter.
Ball one.
Low pitch from Lester, four ball.
That two-seam fastball is such an effective pitch. One, because it gets ground ball outs, but two, it sets up his other pitches.
1-0 delivery is a fastball in there, 1-1.
Recent stats on him, he's picked up just one hit in his last nine at-bats. He just disappeared in that.
Swing sets this one pretty well, deep right center. This one to Ellsbury. That's caught. Side is retired. And so John Lester gets him. That's 1-2-3. Through four innings, he's helping this team stay on top. Just two runs in. On now, last half of the fourth inning. And Johnny Gomes up. One hit already.
Okay. Let's see. Now. Utley should be changed with Young. S. And then Utley should change with Howard. There we go. Now we should be good.
Going for another against Lennon.
And of course, he's not the only guy who's been able to make contact with that two-seamer today. You got to keep looking for it.
And he starts him out. Fastball in there, 0-1. Now this is a kind of an interesting breakdown. You take a look at the pitch types that were thrown that have been hit for a base hit or better.
Well, that two-seamer's been hit several times in this game.
You know, with the hits he's gotten off that pitch you mentioned, John, it's not how he wanted to have this play out. He hasn't been shelled by any means, but he certainly has turned in better performances in the past than this one.
Spotted by Ruiz. That one fouled off by Gomes. And Lennon wide that time. That will be a ball.
He tried to backdoor that pitch, but left it out and away.
Here's the pitch. Pretty bad pitch right there, but nobody on base. 3-2 on the way.
You're out.
Strike three, Johnny Gomes on a swing and a miss.
Took a big hack at that one up in the zone. He's going to be seeing that one in his dreams all night long.
Underwood is the batter now. His first trip to the plate, he went down on strike, striking out against Lanham.
He saw the changeup as the put-away pitch in his last at-bat. You got to believe he's going to be looking for it somewhere during this at-bat as well.
This one's grounded near third, foul. Here's the delivery. Hit hard on the ground to short. And that'll bring up Jacoby Ellsbury. Let's take a moment to check out the top hitting teams around the league. Tigers, number one. Blue Jays in second. Third spot, the Rangers. Fourth, the Red Sox. And number five, the Indians rounded out.
As a team, they are really swinging the bat. Everybody's contributing. The batting average among the best in the game. And they're seeming to find a way to score some runs.
Now, certainly for Jacoby Ellsbury, the 12th season, a lot of injuries. He had an amazing 2011. Everybody thought there'd be a repeat performance, but only 74 games played last year. And the reason Ellsbury's absence, the shoulder injury, one positive was it wasn't more trouble with the ribs, which had bothered him over time. That was back in 2010, Steve.
Well, Ellsbury has had so many bad luck injuries, kind of freak injuries, but what he has shown is when he's healthy, he can hit for average, he can run, and we've seen some power from him as well. He's got a chance to be an all-around player.
The 1-2 pitch. Cannot get a swing on that one. Jacoby Ellsbury is a strikeout victim. Boy, it took four pitches, no wasted time right there, and he got him.
What I liked the most was he was very deliberate with what he had to do. When you don't waste pitches, you put the hitter back on his heels.
So with two down, it'll be Dustin Pedroia. Homered back in the first inning. First pitch to him.
Generally don't like him that much.
That misses inside. Wow.
Basically right through his head.
Teammates got to be feeling pretty good about him right now coming to the plate, knowing he's coming off of his last game.
He
went out of the ballpark,
there,
taking advantage of the pitcher being in
trouble.
Let's
see if I try it again. I'll straighten it out.
At the belt, the 1-0. Oh, he lost control of that one, and that gets him.
Oh, warning. Warning. Next pitcher that hits a batter will be ejected.
And as you might have expected, the way this is going, a warning had to come here. This pitcher's going to have to really rein this thing in. For that matter, both these pitchers, or we're going to have some problems.
Yeah, there's no question about this. And this is about player safety for sure. We're going to see if it changes the way pitchers throw now, if they avoid the inside part of the plate.
Now we're going to see Big Poppy.
And with that hit by pitch we saw there, Gary, now two runners on base. And it's got to be in his mind a little bit right now that he's got to be careful, but he can't be afraid to pitch inside.
And that's the third out, Revere Graphic. They pick up no runs on a hit, and they lead 2-1. Red Sox 4, Phillies 2. The top of the order is due up next. And if you just joined us, our broadcast of Major League Baseball on 2K Sports with John Kruk and Steve Phillips, I'm Gary Thorne. Revere at the plate. He's our first batter here in the fifth. It's strike one, can't make contact on the fastball. How's he been getting strikes? Let's take a look at his approach today. Swung on and ripped towards second. One away. Michael Young at the plate.
Well, Michael Young, one of the most consistent players in baseball over the last several seasons, struggled a little bit last year and fell off, hitting under 280 for the first time since 2002. It didn't have the same kind of pop in his bat we've seen.
Good pitch from Lester, swung out and missed. And for Michael Young, the final totals, 277 average, 8 homers, 169 total hits. Still a good year for most players, but he's been so good, it's a step back, John.
Yeah, when you get compared to how you've been, that's sometimes tough to keep up with. But what you see with Michael Young is what...
This one's pretty well hit to deep left center. This one's going to be fielded by Hairston. Two away.
Now, fun to watch him pitch like this. Last couple innings, nobody getting anything going. He's retired six in a row.
Carlos Ruiz will try and keep it going.
Hoping to try to continue some momentum off of his last game when he picked up 3 base hits. See if he can't keep it going.
Starts him out here. Here's a swing and a liner to left center. That gets down. That'll put him on. The tying run up.
Boy, after 2 outs, they finally got a man on board right here in this inning. So let's see if they can get back-to-back hits going and maybe get some momentum.
Kratz is in the batter's box. He's ready to go. At the belt, Lester kicks, throws. A smash to first. And that's going to go through. That could be trouble. And with that right-hander warming up in the bullpen here, I'm not sure quite what they're thinking.
Well, with the left-handed hitter on deck, he's probably getting ready for hitters later in the lineup.
What a great opportunity here for the Phillies. There are base runners out there for Chase Utley. He had a single in his last time up. Now the first pitch.
Ball!
That's low and outside, 1-0.
They thought maybe the hitter was going to open up the plate. They went with the soft pitch, the curveball, down and away, but he couldn't chase.
Ready with a 1-0. That one fouled off by Utley.
Ball!
Takes a swing at that fastball, doesn't get to it, 1-2. The 1-2 from Lester. That one swung on, hit in the air to deep right center field. Gomes to field this one. And that's out number 3. So John Lester heads to the dugout. He's in line to pick up the win after pitching 5 innings, only 2 runs in. And the Red Sox coming up next. In the batter's box, Salta Lamacchia.
He's been off his game just a little bit, just 3 hits in his last 17.
And he was a non-factor in their last series. He'll look to bounce back and leave his mark in this one.
Lannon with a delivery. Just missed with a fastball, 1-0.
Well, this guy's really eating up some innings for this team. He's over the 60 pitch mark right now. And I tell you what, that's a lot of pitches for a middle relief pitcher.
It's now 1-1. You watch that fastball that was in there.
Some guys really like the low fastball. In this situation, though, he ends up taking the pitch.
Cuts on that fastball. Can't make contact. 1-2. And a moment here to see how this pitcher has been mixing up his pitches.
Well, guys, I mean, that changeup is the pitch we've seen him throw quite a bit here today. But to me, he's throwing it a little bit too much.
You know, one of the things I've been noticing, he has not been throwing the slider as much as we're used to seeing it. And it could be a tremendous weapon for him. We'll see if he leans on it more heavily later in the game, because he needs to find some outs.
Swung on, jump foul towards first.
Well, you know the pitcher wants to get this strikeout right here, but the last thing he wants to do when he's ahead in the count is make a mistake. And the more balls he keeps fouling off in tough situations, the more chance of a mistake coming. Pitcher has to keep his focus right here.
Here's the 2-2 pitch.
Foul!
It's fouled off. He fouls that one off.
Well, the pitcher might just say, you know what, I'm going to throw it down the middle and hope you put it in play and hit it at someone, because I can't strike you out. The 7th pitch of this at bat just gets enough of it to stay alive.
Ball 3!
Slider just about had him, 3-2 count.
I like the way that ball came out of his hand. Good action, good movement, and good depth. Starting at the knees, going out of the zone, the hitter showed good patience.
Here's the payoff pitch. And he swings and hits this one foul.
Well, you would obviously think that the more pitches a pitcher throws, the better chance you have of getting a hit. And right there, he kept himself alive by fouling off that 3-2 pitch low in the zone. This is a great battle.
And another foul ball. Here's the 3-2 pitch. On the ground to second. Played by Utley. And that's in plenty of time for the out. And it's Hairston batting. He has the highest average on the team. And gets set for the first pitch. Fouled off.
He's getting it done all season long, Gary, and a guy they're really looking to count on.
Lannon with a delivery. There's a swing, line drive, center field. And Hairston retired. Two retired here. Now the teams that have been finding their way on base percentage for the last 10. Number one, the Indians. The Tigers second. Third, the White Sox. Fourth, the Red Sox. And the fifth best, the A's. And he throws the first one. Ground ball, Howard on the pickup. And he'll step on first to retire the side. And a good defensive half inning, three up, three down. Red Sox four, Phillies two. It's gonna be Knicks now.
Ball one.
And Lester's wide that time for a ball.
Like I said before, I was going to already do this. I'm going to put warm-up swimmer. Happy to get a five innings in.
Let's the 1-0 pitch go by, 1-1. Here's the 1-1. Fastball gets away from him there, 2-1. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Swings, lines this one back up the middle. And it is in there. That's going to bring the tying run to the plate.
Well, this sort of hit starting out the inning, even though it's just a single, deflating as a pitcher, because now he has to pitch out of the stretch. He has to concern himself with the bunt, but he also has to concern himself with giving up that big inning.
As he gets going against these Philadelphia hitters, what do you think's in store?
Well, when it comes to Koji Yohara, he's a tough guy to match up as a hitter. He's got good velocity on the fastball, an exceptional changeup, and a very good splitter as well.
His last at bat, he ended with a swinging strikeout. 0 for 2 thus far. Well, working on the 0-1 count now.
Well, he clearly fooled him right there. He had him thinking fastball, and he pulled the string on it, got him to swing right through it.
Ball! Good eye by Jimmy Rollins. Stays away from that one, and it evens it up. Last season, two hits, 11 at-bats against the Red Sox. Line drive fouled off towards first. Here's the pitch. Outstanding pitch, and Jimmy Rollins gets caught, and he's gone, strike three.
A good two-strike fastball in on his hand. He couldn't pull the trigger.
And we're going to see Brown here. Grounded out last time up. Runner at first with one down. And the first pitch. Takes that first pitch low in the strike zone. Strike one.
Foul.
And he swings and hits this one foul.
Foul.
And he fouls off another one.
Well, that pitch right there up in the strike zone is a pitch that normally this hitter would drive. But the fact that he's in the hole 0-2, he had to take a more defensive approach, and he just fouled it off.
Got him there. That was a nice strikeout.
This one tails down. Look at it just dropping off the table right there with a big break at 83 miles per hour.
Chance will come with two down for Howard.
Coming into play today, all his teammates wanted to talk about was the fact he drove in four big runs.
Clobbers this ball. A soaring drive deep left center field. Gone! A two-run homer. This two-run homer ties the game, a clutch piece of hitting. And the WPA graph here will give us an idea of what that two RBI home run has done and their chances for a victory.
In this situation, it's exactly what you're looking for when you pull the guy off the bench.
Certainly makes a manager look good when you get a pinch hit home run.
And that's why you have to keep your head in the game when you're not in the lineup originally. You got a chance to deliver. For the Phillies, they've cashed in other opportunities to score, and that's why this game is tied up. One more clutch hit, and they'll be in good shape to take the lead.
Here it comes.
Foul!
He fouls that one off. The pitch. There's a swing. Fly ball down the line and left. This one's going to be fielded by Harrison. And the sides retired as they head into the dugout. They come up with two runs to pull even. We got a stalemate going in Boston. Latter third of the lineup coming up. Ross. And we'll get to see Michael Schwimmer pitching as the Phillies bring him in as a reliever.
I'm sure they didn't set out thinking, hey, let's pitch all our bullpen guys this early in the game. What do you think, Gary? I don't know. They need this guy to hold down the fort and see if he can't give them some innings.
He stops. He doesn't want to come to the mound. He's afraid. Oh, there he goes. Even Charlie lost weight in this one.
First pitch to him. Sharp curveball. Swung on and missed. 0-1.
Well, he saw that breaking ball right out of the pitcher's hand. You see this cut he had. This is a power swing right here. He's trying to go yard.
Swung on and fouled away.
Foul!
Here's the pitch. And he fouls another one off. Hit in the dirt. Picked up by Rollins. So Ross is retired.
He could make a video on how to field his position. He gets over and makes it look easy. Solid fundamentals out at first base.
Story of power hitting. We'll look at the long ball league leaders. Number one, the Red Sox. The Angels in second. Third, the Yankees. The Tigers fourth. And the fifth best, the A's.
Well, there's a lot of power in this lineup, Gary, and I tell you, it's a nightmare for any pitcher. You know, usually you have one or two guys that can take you out of the ballpark. They have a plethora of guys who can do damage. If one doesn't get you, the next one will.
And the first pitch was a strike. Got about 0-1 right now.
Strike two.
Strike strike two, no balls, two strikes. Gomes will protect. There's a swing, and that one's hit on the ground. Gets through, the go-ahead run is on.
Guy tries to sneak one down and in to get the strike three call, but he fights it off. Outstanding job at the plate.
And that is so demoralizing for a pitcher. You work so hard to get ahead in the count, and then you give up a base hit.
Okay, well, looks like Rollins somehow hurt his shoulder. I don't know who that kid is, but apparently he was in our minor league system or something, or well, at least in this game. I'm pretty sure it's a made-up guy. So.
Looks as if he's done something to his shoulder on that last play. He's in a good deal of pain. Erickson, he'll be taking over due to the injury.
Well, this is why you have a 25-man roster. You're going to have injuries, and guys have to step in and get the job done behind you.
1-0 count. You took that last one, and it was out of the zone.
Well, any hitting coach will tell you, you can't hit that good high fastball, especially if it's out of the strike zone. It's a pitch you have to lay off of, make him bring it down to give yourself a chance.
1-1, a fastball inside, 2-1 now. Ground ball to short. It's picked up. On to first, two away.
I could have had a double play.
Had a double play right there, but at least they got one out. And now a runner is going to position at second base.
Yeah, I forgot about that guy.
Getting an opportunity to really
concentrating on my injury.
It could be an interesting showdown to watch right here. Now he's an offensive machine last time out, a hitting clinic with four base hits in his last game.
First pitch he let go by, and it was a ball, 1-0.
Oops.
And Rivera's going to play it. And that's out number three. So they pick up a hit, but leave a man at second and fail to score. And it'll be the Phillies. Michael Young leading it off. Flew out last time. First pitch of the AB. There's a swing and a liner. Out throws in time to first. What a play. Diving stop and a nice throw too.
Guy showed great range on that one. I didn't think he had any chance to get it, but they able to get it and get on his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Tremendous job.
Carlos Ruiz batting now with one down. Drove in a run earlier in the game. He delivers just off the outside, and it's 1-0. The 1-0 now. A line drive towards short. Little warm-up action going in the bullpen. That's a right-hander up and throwing.
Well, they're going to wait for the right-handed hitter on deck to get it now.
Reminds me. Okay. More of a horse.
And then he'll probably make the move to the pen.
Kratz is in the batter's box. He's ready to go. He doubled his last time. The second, there's one. And a double play, they got a vote. So no runs on one hit and nobody left on. We are still deadlocked in Boston. It'll be batters 2 through 4 due up next. And if you were just tuning in, hi, Gary Thard along with John Crux, Steve Phillips. We bring you Major League Baseball on 2K Sports. And it's Dustin Pedroia in the box now. Homered back in the first inning. And Rivera's going to play it as he just strolls over for that out. So with one away, here's David Ortiz.
Well, so much for the questions as Big Poppy does. We heard that in the past, but he's continuing to prove he's got some baseball left. He's an RBI machine.
Fastball misses away, 1-0. Well, for David Ortiz, certainly an RBI machine when he's healthy. Missed a good deal of time last season, but still looks like he can be that big DH in your lineup. Line shot into center field, And that is in there, the go-ahead run on base.
A real good approach at the plate right here, thinking about going back up the middle. He gets a fastball a little bit inside, but able to just punch it up. Up the middle for a base hit.
In the batter's box, Santalamacchia. Last year, he had a 4-for-10 against the Phillies. It's going to be Jeremy Horst on the mound. He'll be the reliever for the Phillies.
This is where the manager earns his money. Let's see if this move pays off.
Pitch on the way. And it's fouled off.
Foul ball!
One fastball and a called strike.
Foul!
It's fouled off. Change up called strike three. That's the second out.
At 86 miles per hour and as flat as that, pretty dangerous pitch right there.
And he gets rung up in a pitch that catches the bottom of the strike zone. That's where he wanted to put that one.
Yeah, and I don't think he's going to agree with the call, but it was fair. You got to swing the bat in that situation.
Just a view of the teams who have crossed the plate the most times this year. Number one, the Red Sox. Second, the Angels. The Blue Jays, third. The Yankees, fourth. And for the Tigers, fifth.
Well, you talk about a high-octane offense. This team is number one in all of baseball in runs scored. And how do they do it? Any way you can imagine. Take the ball out of the ballpark? Yeah, they get that one done. Get on base, steal a base, and score on a single? Yeah, they'll do that too. You name it, they do it. That's why they cross home plate better than anyone in baseball.
Swings at that fastball and misses 0-1.
That's a huge swing right there. He was looking for a fastball, but just couldn't quite catch up to it. Great pitch.
Lays off that fastball, and it's 0-2.
A nice four-seamer right there. That one's clearly on the outside corner. He hit the spot.
That's a foul ball.
Foul!
And Ruiz is calling for the pitch. And that swung on and hit. And Revere. And there's the third out. No runs on a hit, and they'll strand him. And there's Chase Utley at the plate. He's going to get a start in eighth inning. Here we go with the first pitch.
Ball one.
Splitter just misses. 1-0.
But great.
Frustrates me sometimes. It's like you want to go warm up somebody in the bullpen, but you can't do it because, well, the pause menu isn't ready for you yet.
Great eye right there from the hitter. Great discipline at the plate. Good location at that one. Just missing outside. Couldn't get the hitter to swing at it.
The 1-1. Strike two with a swing and a miss on a fastball.
Well, that's some kind of pitch, and you set up the target on the outside corner, and he paints the black with it. Awfully tough when you have that kind of location.
This is swung on, lifted to deep right field. As he retreats back for it and gets the out.
Well, he followed the scouting reports. They moved the outfielders back before the play, and they were in exactly the right position to be able to make the catch. Good coaching.
Nix is batting. And as he gets into this Philadelphia lineup, Steve, strategy-wise?
Well, you get a look at Andrew Bailey here coming in. He's a guy who attacks the zone, but always finds a way to keep the ball down in the zone and keep it in the ballpark.
Singleton scored his last time around. Swings and misses at the fastball. That'll leave in the count at 1.
I'm climbing the ladder on him right there. He just throws that fastball right by him up in the zone.
Line towards third and foul. Big swing and a drive. Deep left center field going back to the wall. And he drops back to the warning track to pull it in. Erickson batting now.
Got to love number 86 in the lineup.
Swing and a miss on the cutter. 0-1.
But just way out in front of that cutter.
Swung on and hit. Ellsbury there. And there's Pedroia for out number 3. And with this ball game tied, probably not a bad idea, Steve, to have that closer ready to go.
Well, it sends a message to the offense that you're expecting them to score, and the closer's going to be ready to save the game.
Good defensive half inning there. No. Middlebrooks in the batter's box. And we've got Mike Adams pitching. He'll be the reliever for the Phillies.
Well, in the late innings, now it's time for the managers to match wits to see who can best utilize his bench and his bullpen to win this game.
I think the big Charlie Wade. Just stand there. Oh, no, he probably comes. Nobody walks the aisles here.
First pitch is a slider in there. Oh, no.
That's what the breaking ball does. It starts in the zone and breaks out of the zone. Usually a good low ball hitter can try to do something with it. Let's see what he can do.
Swing and a bouncing ball up the middle, played by Utley. And that'll retire Middlebrooks. Here are the teams with the most extra base knocks around the league. The Red Sox, number 1. Blue Jays in 2nd. 3rd, the Rays, the Yankees 4th, and at number 5, it's the Angels.
A lot of people think that power is just hitting home runs, but this team dispels that myth. They're not just trying to hit a single the other way. They're trying to drive something the other way, down the line or in a gap for extra bases. They love putting themselves in scoring position. That's why they can score multiple runs in an inning, because of all those extra base hits.
Swinging a ball, pop foul down the right field line. Fastball got him, 2 down. Boy, those strikeouts so important coming late in the ball game. Keeps that confidence up.
Well, they tell you that strikeouts add to the pitch count, but a 3-pitch strikeout right there, he can go forever on that one.
The chance with 2 down for Johnny Gomes. 2-for-3 thus far. And Adams gets him swinging. That's the first strike.
Boy, that's some kind of fastball down to the zone right there. The hitter has to be ready for it, or he's got no chance to hit it.
There's a swing in play. This one's to Revere. Brown's there. And he's there to retire the side. Nothing doing here in this half inning. We got a stalemate going in Boston. Two reads on a game always from each dugout. Let's take a look at it from Charlie Manuel's perspective. At this point, every move is critical. He hasn't got any margin for error. And
okay, so I'm going to get him warmed up. And if he can't go, I'm going to put Valdez in the game for a long relief. So.
Now we've got Joe Hanrahan. They've decided it was time to make a change here.
Right to.
Really extended his arms that time, but 0-2.
The pitcher's way ahead. He's got some room here now to play with some pitches. Don't be too fine giving him something good to hit.
There's a ground ball, and Pedroia picks it up. So Brown is retired. Ryan Howard at the plate had a home run back in the sixth. Strike one, Hanrahan got him to swing 0-1.
Well, he recognized that two-seamer. It seemed like his timing was right there, but he tried to turn on it and just came up empty.
Ball. Good eye by Ryan Howard. Lays off that one and we're even.
Well, you see there, he tried to go on that outside corner down and away. Give the hitter a lot of credit, though. You know that's a pitch you can't hit, so don't even swing at it. Well, and the catcher looked like he really wanted that one.
And he looks at a fastball in there. That's 1-2 now.
I normally just go for a contact, but I'm going to go for power here just to see if I can get a home run to win this thing.
That one fouled off by Howard.
Catch throwing it so hard.
Howard again will foul it away.
Well, he's going to have to keep this same approach if he wants this at bat to go on. That's a pitch right there that possibly could have put in play. He's lucky, though, he fouled it off because you can't do a lot with that high pitch.
Foul ball!
Howard battling another foul ball. And that one swung out of miss by Ryan Howard.
But here's the pitching sequence he used. It took seven pitches to keep this game close.
Well, the battle goes the way of the pitcher. That's a great performance right there late in the ballgame.
Well, sometimes as a hitter, you just have to tip your hat to the pitcher. Seven pitches, he made quality pitches, and he got the big strikeout.
And a chance here with two down for Ben Revere. He flew out his last time up.
Foul!
That one goes foul. Hit up the middle, Pedroia. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. And they're held in check here in this half inning. Still a tie game in Boston. Bottom part of the order will get their chance offensively. A look at the viewpoint of John Farrell and how this game's moving. This is where the at-bats are. He doesn't want to have to go to extras if he can help it. Underwood at the plate now. He has the support of the home fans right now. He's their first chance here in the bottom half of the night. They're hoping he can get something. Ground ball towards second. Played by Utley. In time for the out.
Jacoby Ellsberg getting an opportunity to really impact this game. It'll be an interesting showdown to watch right here.
The home crowd is hoping, and this may be their final hope, maybe their best hope, a chance to win it here in the bottom half of the last inning.
Now the crowd electric right now, excited, on their feet. They know two of the game's best going head-to-head.
Here's the 1-0. Oh, change up just off the black. Falls behind, 2-0.
Well, that pitch right there, that changeup away, if a guy's looking for it, that's a great pitch to be able to hit the other way with some power.
The 2-0 pitch, a fastball, but he missed. Strike one.
He looked really out of sync on that swing. Swung late. Looks like he wasn't anticipating the fastball.
Here's a swing and a ground ball. Picked up by Young. Two away. So with two down, it'll be Dustin Pedroia. He homered earlier in the ballgame. The first pitch, rolls back, and it's a called strike on the inside part of the plate, 0-1.
That fastball just froze him on the inside corner. Now we're going to see where he goes. Look for something soft, possibly away.
Strike two with that. No balls, two strikes. Pedroia now, short in the swing, shorten up on the bat. The pitch. Oh, tough one to lay off right there, that fastball. 1-2. And Dustin Pedroia watches that one go by. The count is even. Pedroia will foul that one away. Pedroia fouls off another.
Well, even though the count's even, you still have to take that defensive mode up with the plate, because anytime you have two strikes, you don't want to give him a cheap out just by striking out foolishly. But he's keeping this at bat alive on that low pitch to foul it off.
Swung and a ground ball to third. Throws to first in time. That's three down. It's the kind of inning the defense likes, three up, three down. And we'll head to extra frames here in Boston. Take a look now at this ball game from Charlie Manuel's hideaway. This is where you hope you have that lineup inspired enough to get the offense you need and get the club back in it. And Michael Young up. He grounded out his last time up. Slider swung on and missed. 0-1.
Well, you see that pitch coming in, and it starts at the center of the plate, and all of a sudden, as soon as you start your swing, that's when that slider starts breaking away, gets out of the strike zone away. He can't stop his swing, and swings and misses.
And that's another foul ball.
Well, you have an 0-2 count. That pitcher comes up in the strike zone. You know he's looking for that strikeout. Now you take a little bit of confidence away from him with the fact that you can foul that pitch up in the zone off to live to see another day.
Now, K-Cam's going to show us a good look at this slider. I got quite a showdown we have right here. Carlos Ruiz trying to match up and see what he can do to impact this game.
Top half of this extra inning, and this is where these battles between hitters and pitchers become very intense.
If you talk to both of these managers, Gary, they'd say, I want this pitcher on the mound, and the other would say, I want this hitter at the plate.
Foul ball!
Hanrahan is ahead now, 0-2.
But when in doubt, when you're undecided, swing hard, and that's what he did. But he got the slider and he swung through it, but a big, powerful swing.
Swung on and missed strike three. Carlos Ruiz, no piece of that one.
Well, he helped him right there with two strikes. He gets the slider, but he chases it out of his own for strike three.
Kratz is in the batter's box. He's ready to go. He's had one hit, four times up. Hanrahan fooled him on that one. Popped into foul territory, down the left side. Thought he could make a play there, but it didn't happen. Struck him out, so they'll go to work, see if they can't win it in the bottom half. And nothing across here in this half of the inning. We got a stalemate going in Boston.
David Ortiz, Mr. Clutch at the plate, looking to set up the fireworks here, Gary.
Bottom half of this extra inning, you want to win this right now, and he's got a chance to do it.
Well, he's got to be feeling the pressure, no question about it, and all it takes is a big fly to end this game, so let's see if he pitches around him a little bit.
Here's the pitch. Good patience as David Ortiz lets that one go by. The count is even. This with a curve, 2-1. Now Now the 2-1 pitch. There's a swing and a drive, deep right field. As he drops back for it and puts it away.
They followed the advanced scout reports to a T. They played the outfielder's back that time, and he hit it right into the teeth of the defense.
In the batter's box, Santalamacchia looking to call third strike in his last at bat. And here's the first one. Fouled away.
Foul!
Here's the delivery.
Ball!
Too far inside, 1-1. The 1-1 on the way. There's a swing and a liner towards the gap in left field. That one in the alley. This could be two or more.
You talk about a happy guy right there, and so is his manager. Getting there to second base, two outs to work with now for his offense. Let's see if his teammates can bring him in.
Hairston has a turn of the month. And he is batting here late in the game in a crucial spot.
Well, you've got a base runner. You don't know if you're going to get another opportunity. The game may be on the line right here.
This is the chance at a game-winning RBI. A couple of RBIs thus far.
Yes, we already know it.
Here's the first pitch. That swung on line towards the gap in left center.
That's the game.
It rolls all the way to the wall. And game over. The winning run scores, and that's a wrap.
Well, the hometown fans going home in celebratory fashion, Gary, as they win this one in the final inning, getting it done in an unbelievable game.
Come to that point where we take a look back and say, who made a difference? It's our player of the game. Talk about a great game. It was Scott Hairston.
Well, coming into the game, you told someone you're going to get two hits today, you'd be very happy. The average goes up, and everything else is good for you. But the bottom line is, those two hits were the reason this team won the game. And it shows, because he's our player of the game.
And Steve, that ought to send these folks home happy.
No question about it. They get the win in a close game, a lot of excitement and enthusiasm, and ready for the next one.
This is Gary Thorne with John Kruk and Steve Phillips. Hope you had a great time, as good as we did. Then you're all set. See you next time.
See, they have like a little wrap-up thing. It's like top three plays, signature highlights. So, anyway, I hope you enjoyed this.
This is David B69, and I'm out.